terms of etiology, we know that biological factors are important, genetics are important. In the general population, approximately 0.5 to 1% of people develop schizophrenia. However, if you have a first degree biological relative with schizophrenia, for example, a parent or a sibling, the odds of you also developing the disorder go up to around 10%. This jump is certainly suggestive of the importance of shared DNA. However, the real clincher is twin studies. For monozygotic twins, also known as identical twins, where the DNA material is identical, if one of the twins develops schizophrenia, the odds of the other twin developing schizophrenia increase to around 50%. These are pretty compelling numbers. Adoption studies have also been important in terms of evidence for genetic transmission. By and large, these studies have found that even if adopted at birth by parents who do not have schizophrenia, the biological offspring of a parent with schizophrenia are at increased odds of developing the disorder relative to the general population. However, in thinking about the twin and adoption research, it's really important to keep in mind that genetics do not tell us the whole story of why some people develop schizophrenia and not others. If it were simply about genetic influences, in theory, we should be looking at a 100% concordance rate between monozygotic twins rather than a 50% concordance rate. Genes are hugely important, but increasingly, the biological research is indicating that a gene by environment interaction is likely to be the best way of understanding the etiology of schizophrenia. This idea is something I will come back to shortly. There are a number of other lines of research that support the role of biological factors in the development of schizophrenia. People with schizophrenia have been found to have structural brain abnormalities compared to people who do not have the disorder. Biochemical abnormalities, particularly involving the neurotransmitter dopamine, have also been implicated in the development of schizophrenia, with an individual's genetic predisposition a probable cause of the chemical imbalance. Finally, people with schizophrenia are more likely than people without the disorder to have been exposed to pregnancy and birth complications that may have caused structural damage to the brain. So, we've looked at biological and genetic factors. Let's turn our attention now to environmental factors. If we think about social factors first, we know that low socioeconomic status, or SES, is associated with the incidence of schizophrenia. Having said that, it's important to emphasise that schizophrenia is certainly not restricted to people who have come from a lower socioeconomic background. It's just more likely that people with schizophrenia will come from a low SES background. Some of the potentially harmful characteristics associated with lower SES include stress, social isolation, poor nutrition, and lack of access to medical services. But it's really difficult to disentangle this association between schizophrenia and lower SES. Do the stressors associated with living in a lower socioeconomic demographic influence the likelihood that an individual will develop schizophrenia? Or, equally possible, does this association exist because if an individual has schizophrenia, they are more likely to end up in a lower socioeconomic demographic as they're not able to hold down a job? Regardless, we know that if you have schizophrenia, your biological offspring are at increased risk relative to the general population of developing this disorder. It's somewhat unclear as to whether living in a lower socioeconomic demographic adds to the risk in this equation. A second social factor that has been linked to the incidence of schizophrenia is social dislocation. Higher rates of schizophrenia have been found among people who have migrated to a new country compared to people who have not experienced this kind of social dislocation. With regard to psychological factors, expressed emotion is the construct that has been most researched. Expressed emotion refers to the level of criticism, hostility, and emotional over-involvement that exists within a family. The research indicates that people with schizophrenia who live in a family with a high level of negative expressed emotion are significantly more likely to relapse compared to those with schizophrenia living in a family with a low level of negative expressed emotion. This finding, which has been well replicated, is important. However, I think it's also really important to consider the issue of family burden. try for a moment to imagine what it would be like to live in a family environment with someone, a parent, a child, or a sibling suffering from schizophrenia. When we are looking at family-related risk factors, it's really critical not to fall into the trap of blaming family members.